problems that women have can be attributed to patriarchy and our own culture, which emphasize that women should be meek, should listen to the men, should do as they are asked to do. And we've grown up with this, and I grew up knowing that I was a lesser person than my brothers.
I realized that women were discriminated and they didn't know their legal rights. And because of that, they were not able to participate fully in the development spheres.
I don't want to say it is so much cultural that women, Maasai women, don't get into politics or leadership, but it is the politicians who play to the culture of the Maasais to use that culture to try and bar the women.
I saw a lot of atrocities and abuses of human rights, and that triggered a passion that lasted until I was able to get into parliament, in the hope that we could correct through our parliamentary proceedings some of those abuses that occurred, and especially those that are meted on women and children. So I guess that is how I took an interest in politics and got in there in 1979. Women must not be afraid to get into power, because they are made to get into that power. It is very easy to frighten a woman to chicken out by abusing her. Like, for example, some men would go so low to discredit a woman that a woman would feel, well, maybe I shouldn't even try this because I'm not good enough. That being good enough, not being good enough, is something that women must get rid of from their psyche, from their thinking, because they are indeed good enough and can do whatever men have been able to do.
I think we've come a long way, and I think we are moving in the right direction, because first of all, the Constitution has empowered a woman.
I think this country is in for very big surprises, because we have some of the best brains among the women who have been given those responsible positions in our government. And we have begun to see changes which this country will realize in the next 4 or 5 years. And I believe Kenya will never want to go back to those idiotic way of thinking.
In terms of women turning out for elective positions, I'll also say, I think because of the history of how politics have been perceived to be a very murky affair, you know, to be, you know, as a woman, the moment you want to vie, people will paint you with mud all over, you know, and you, of course, you know, women, you're a bit conservative, you know, you don't want really to be portrayed in a certain way. And I think that is why women shy away from that.
I know the challenges I faced as a woman when I was trying to campaign. One is a notion, a perception by the general public that politics is a male business, and especially from the community which I come from. The literacy level of the community is too low. What I mean is there is a lot of illiteracy, and that has again played very negatively to the women, because the male politicians are people who will entice the population with the, you know, handouts. They will entice the population with even incitement, and any typical woman cannot afford to do that. So that again is limiting the women into the leadership spheres.
For all political parties, nobody will tell you today that the processes for nominations are really fair. They are normally manipulated, induced by money. There is a lot of political game changing, you know, and backstabbing, and of course, thuggery and electoral violence. When you put all that together, and crowd building, you know, like parties belong to owners, and these owners are hardly women. And therefore, for a woman to be able to capture a nomination ticket, it becomes, I think, the biggest drawback.
Yeah. The exercise that occurred today is null and void. It is manipulation. We would actually like to appeal to our former chairperson to support the officials that were registered on Thursday. We must stop impunity. We shall resist any attempt to sabotage, any attempt to bring impunity.
I think that the Political Parties Act needs to be combed through, to be amended, so that it makes it mandatory, obligatory. It obligates political parties to assist women to actually be nominated. Because once you are nominated by parties that are also supporting campaigns, you know, then it is easier to have more numbers.
If you look at our Vision 2030, there's a lot of what we discussed in Beijing that is now reflected in our Vision 2030. But there are other areas of concern that we still want to pursue and to work on. One, of course, in representation of women, which is not yet 33%. That was what we agreed, or not 30%. It was supposed to be 33%. But in this country, it should be 50%, even 51%, because there are our population is 51% women and 49% men. And that should dictate our representation at various levels, especially now that our women, our girls have done very well.
One thing, and the major thing, is education. Because the more you educate the Maasai woman, the more you educate the Maasai man, the more they get to appreciate the different genders and what roles we can play in leadership.
So for me, I think we need to create a lot of awareness to women. We need empowerment in terms of making them believe in themselves, in terms of also making them aware that these opportunities are there, they should go for them. In terms of knowledge or information is power, okay? Also knowing what the Constitution says and what their rights are, and also making also women understand the politics is not really, it may be dirty, but we can change. Though as a country could be, we've not gotten into, could be the level of the development countries, where it could be the kind of politics they play is a bit different from us. Because if you've ever been in a campaign trail, you know how things get nasty at times, especially the last moment. You know, propagandas are thrown from, you know, left, right, and every corner, you know. So at the end of the day, you might not get the right person. But I think Kenya is changing. If you look at even the people who are elected, who are in parliament, even right now, even at the ward level, we've seen the common mwananchi being able to make decisions now based on issues.
I think that women must learn to invest and keep there, stay on, and build on whatever gains they make during the first attempts. Because after all, it's, and I have said, even men, if you look at this parliament, most people have been there the first time and they lose. It's because women, when they try first, then they lose. Then they are not able to. These are important gains. You know, experience will help you to come out a better person the next elections. So I would advocate women who really want to come on board, first, they must start early, because also I think age becomes a factor in terms of also focus, in terms of planning. So we also should start a bit earlier than the time I started. I started at around 41, and I'm sure then you can start calculating how old I am. But so I think we need also to start and mentor women early enough, so that they are starting at around maybe 18, 20, when they are young, you know, even from the university level, so that by the time they are 25, they are easily electable because they've already created sufficient visibility.
The problem and the biggest corruption is with the people. And until the people stop being corrupt.
But why are they corrupt?
I think this is time. We have no excuses, women. I think there's no way you'll get leadership. Leadership, you have to take it. You have to come out and show interest that you want to be elected, so that now the electorate can make a choice. I think the time is here. The opportunity is there, but I think it's upon us to come out as women and participate in politics, because politics is a way of life.
Let women take these positions, and let's try them. Let's see. Give them 5 years. See what happens. And I believe in my heart of hearts that Kenya will see great changes, and we could surprise the world. We could perhaps be one of the countries that is envied by most of these countries around us. I believe these women will do it, but they must be brave, they must be bold, they must stand up for their conviction, and they must convince this country and the government that they serve that they are up to the task, and that their ideas are researched, and that they will augur well for us all.